point is AC equal to 5 by beta, that equal to 0.5. So the pole is 1 by beta t equal to 0.01. So the compensated ZC of S equal to 0.5 into S plus 0.1 divided by S plus 0.01. This is the Bode plot of G of S. This is the Bode plot of compensated GC of S. Bode diagram for G1 of G omega equal to 5 G of G omega. The gain adjusted KC beta G of G omega, open loop transfer function. GC of G omega divided by K, that equal to GC of G omega divided by 5. The compensator divided by gain KC beta equal to 5. The GC of J omega into G of J omega, compensated open loop transfer function. The effect of lag compensator is, these are all the general effects. The original unstable closed loop system is now stable. Initially the system is stable, now after applying the lag compensator, the system becomes stable. The phase margin is approximately 40 degrees, which implies the acceptable transient response. The gain margin is approximately 11 dB, which implies that acceptable transient response. The velocity constant is 5 as required, the acceptable steady state response. The gain at high frequencies has been decreased. In the previous classes, we have seen the lead compensator and lag compensator. Now we are going to see the lead lag compensator. The lead lag compensator, GC of S equal to 1 plus S by T1 divided by 1 plus gamma A by T1 is the lead compensator. Lag compensator is S plus 1 by T2 divided by S plus 1 by beta T2, which implies that to simplify this, you will be writing it as like this. Kc beta ST1 plus 1 divided by gamma ST1 by gamma plus 1 into ST2 plus 1 S beta T2 plus 1. T1 comma T2 is greater than 0, beta is greater than 0 and gamma is greater than 0. The frequency, the Bode plot for that will be like this. The Bode diagram of lag lead compensator is given as like this. GC of S equal to KC into S plus T1 divided by S plus gamma T1 into S plus T2 divided by S plus 1 plus beta T2. Where Kc is 1, gamma is beta, that equal to 10, T2 equal to 10 T1. The polar plot of lead lag lead compensator is given as like this. At omega equal to 0, find the magnitude and angle. Magnitude is 1, angle is 0 degrees. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 1, angle is 0 degrees. So for the same, for this lag lead compensator, if you draw the polar plot, it will be like this. Where Kc equal to 1 and gamma equal to beta. Now let me see the comparison between lead and lag compensators. Lead compensator always acts as high pass filter. Lag compensator is low pass filter. The lead compensator approximates derivative plus proportional controller. The lag compensator approximates integral plus proportional controller. Lead compensator contributes the phase lead. Lag compensator attenuates at high frequencies. increase the lead compensator increases the gain crossover frequency. Lag compensator moves the gain crossover frequency lower. The lead compensator increases the bandwidth, and whereas lag compensator reduces the bandwidth. You can observe here, lead compensator acts as high pass filter and lag compensator acts as low pass filter. To remember, the low is having, to remember, lag compensator acts as low pass filter, the lead compensator acts as high pass filter. Remember this, most the many competitive exams will be asking you. The lag compensator acts as low pass, high pass, band desert. Most of the students will be getting confusion. Lag compensator acts as high pass and sometimes lag compensator acts as high pass always. See here we are having three letters in the lag. The low also is having three letters. So the lag compensator acts as low pass filter. The lead compensator acts as high pass filter. In this way, you need to remember blind marks. With this, your fourth unit has been completed. If you have any doubt regarding your fourth unit or third unit, please let me know. I'll be taking one online class after completion of fifth unit. Completely, if you have any doubt, there we will be clarifying your doubts.